Hello everyone, this is Fair Pencil the artist, and I'm here right now live. And as you can see, what I'm going to do is to retouch all my artwork that I have done before. And yeah, there it is. I show you guys. I'm going to color this one. And especially this one. This one, I think I'll focus first because this artwork needs a lot of details. So yes, and I just become live because for this, okay. But first, I'm going to scatter my live stream first. Jerry, how you doing? Okay, I'll just thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, son. I cannot hear you very well.
How's that?
Yeah, that's good. I'm going to turn off this sound.
Yeah, I was wondering. I thought she said 10 o'clock Philippine time.
Ooh.
Which would have been, eight o'clock in the morning my time. I was awake waiting.
You know what happened? The Malaysian guy is not available. This is the reason. Yeah. Because Patrick Clark is not available. This is the reason why she needs to cancel it. And she was in the other live stream. But you cannot come up over there because that's a different community.
Yeah, she could have still did a live stream.
Save it for tomorrow instead, later.
I'll be out on the road then.
Tonight in your time.
Or tonight? Tonight be morning your time? Oh, that'll work out.
Yeah.
Because I'm still stuck here until tomorrow.
Yes.
Truck's running like a kitten now. Got my issues fixed. Now I won't be freezing to death. My thermostat was stuck open, and I wasn't getting any heat.
So, are you doing over there?
I was just fiddling around with my K1 to make sure it's operable and working correctly.
Yeah, for tomorrow, be ready. At least you can practice more.
Well, I'm doing some other songs I have never tried before. We'll give this one a try, see what happens.
Yeah. You can practice here if you like. Wow.
Well, I'm going to tease her about it.
Right.
I know what she wants to hear.
In live stream, you know what? If we talk about Darren, I don't want to talk about that.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you.
I mean, if the topic is all about Darren, I think we just keep it for it because I think Darren will be the one who will fix it about this problem.
Yeah, I ain't got no problem with Darren. Darren was the man. Darren manned up, apologized, it's over.
The problem is the girls, you know, and the other one is keep on producing a lot of live stream, but I'm not going to mention the name.
Yeah, but the girl accepted the apology.
But how come still those video is pointing to him? It's more on negativity.
Yeah, what's probably going on still is probably about the supposed photos.
Yeah.
See, that's all everybody knew. Nobody knew about what happened, what took place at Jay's house.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And if Jay hadn't mentioned it, nobody would have known about it.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to beat up Jay about it. It's just a live and learn thing. You know, like, hey, if only so few people know, then there's no reason to mention it on a live stream.
Yeah. I already told him that, why did you mention it in your live stream? He said, I'm not attacking Darren. It's he wants to say what he feels.
Yeah, but what the rumor was going around was these so-called photos.
The photos, oh my God. I don't want to get involved with that problem because that's a very offensive, and it can be led into a court.
Mm-hmm.
Because honestly speaking, in the Philippines, especially in Rapitulco, there's a lot of Filipina complaining that their boyfriends uploaded their photos or put it in a porn site. That is offense, a big offense in the Philippines. And the person, whoever uploaded those pictures, will be in jail, not the one who was posing.
There's so many females, even there are so many Filipinas that have got something up there, whether it be a videos, multiple videos, pictures. No one's really going to know. Mm-hmm. And it's like a crapshoot. It's like, okay, who is this one? Now, if you don't put their name and number, nobody's really going to know who that is because there's so many.
The thing is, Darren, it was in the cell phone. There is a name.
Uh-huh.
So the one who discovered it, she's claiming that there is a name. So I don't want to name those people who are they because, honestly speaking, those nude photos and pictures, it's a personal. The person is keeping it for personal. How come you uploaded it and show it to everyone without any consent of the owner, which is a big foul?
Yeah, I have received photos of that nature, and I wouldn't share them with nobody.
Yeah, that's my point. But there are some people, they keep on claiming, oh, they show it to me. How come they will show it to you if you found it on the cell phone and you scattered it?
Uh-huh.
And the person don't show up.
Yeah, you share it on the internet. It won't take long, and then it gets found out. And
this is the reason I don't want to get involved, because this is a very, very critical, critical situation, Sean.
Yeah, it's real low, and I wouldn't do it myself.
There are so many YouTubers, they don't care about this issue, honestly. And you know, there's a one YouTuber said, if the guy doesn't like you anymore, then move on. Stop doing that.
Yeah.
I'm not going to mention who is this YouTuber. They are getting annoyed in that issue anyway. And plus the person that they're attacking, they don't mind it. They don't care about what you're saying. So why are you wasting your time? You know?
Yeah, if there's a certain individual that has, compromising photos of me, it wouldn't bother me one bit she posted those, because I think I'd get the opposite reaction. Like, ooh, who's that?
It's a criminal offense.
Wouldn't bother me.
Yeah.
All the Panays would be like, hey, I just saw your photo. I'm like, okay. I know what they would be contacting me for.
Yeah. Because if you are doing this, for popularity, it's not good.
No, it's not.
Because I don't want to get involved, but I'm getting irritated. Because first of all, Darren is my friend. I really don't know the real issue. So I guess when we meet up, I think I will ask him, what is this all about? There is always a route about this. Leonard Blond is here. Hello.
Hi, Leonard.
Yeah. There is another channel that you cannot talk about that, because this person doesn't allow anyone to talk about that issue. I'm not going to mention this.
We got three Sean's that hang around. We got two Leonards, right? Because Len Whistler is actually, his name is Leonard. He just goes by Len by short, I think.
Yeah. And the person cannot, cannot do anything. He is stuck in one place because of this harassment.
Yeah.
This harassment already.
Yeah, you everybody painted him to be a bad guy, and that's not a good thing to do. It was even with half the story.
Yeah,
I'd be like,
even if you're hurt, you shouldn't do that. That's too much.
Yeah, I mean, plus you got to prove who the individual is. You could take a picture of anybody's junk and say, hey, this person sent me their junk. You know, like, okay, I don't see a face in the photo. Just like, you show me a nude photo of a girl and they say, oh, it's this girl here. I'm like, well, I don't see her face. So that doesn't prove anything. But when it all comes down to it, I go by what I learned in the medical field, even though I wasn't in it. My ex is a doctor. It's all the same. It just comes to a question of when you turn the light out, who washed? That's it. That's the only difference. Who took a shower and who didn't? It's all the same.
It's irritating, honestly. It's irritating. You know, every time I open up my live stream, they're always talk about this issue. Come on.
Oh, crap. I forgot my phone. You just saw me walk across here. I'm going to my room. I got to come back and grab my phone, but I'm going to put all this stuff in here. I had to do a little bit of shopping.
Yeah.
Got some coffee and stuff.
Really irritating, every time they're pointing this guy.
You can see me on camera, can't you? Going in my room?
Yeah.
Okay, I kind of figured. I had to drop my bag of waters. I got to go back and get my cell phone. I like this place, the Econo Lodge, because behind you is a fence where I parked on, where I backed in. There's a fence back there, and then there's a small parking lot, and there's another motel. I'll show you when I get my phone. And there's a balcony. It's two floors. They put the privacy fence up for a reason, because you see that? The balcony there.
Oh, yes.
Motel 6 and Motel 8 are famous for that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. There's somebody staying in these rooms? Okay.
Oh, we're just talking something. Those people who are...
I'm sorry?
Because Leonard Lund, did I miss something? What we are talking about.
They all are leaving?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, all right. The reason why I ask is because I don't like making a whole lot of noise and wake people up. Sorry about that, Sheer.
Yeah.
See, I'm all set up here.
Wow, you're set up. You can practice now.
Talk to who?
You can practice now. You're singing. You can sing here.
Yeah, that this is, I left it on Rosalie's channel for watch hours for her. Mm-hmm. She was the only one doing a live stream, and then I took off, and then you started doing one.
Because on Sunday, I'm going to the funeral of my auntie, and she's cremated.
She's what?
She's cremated. Cremated.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's popular in the Philippines. I've always known that.
And as a pay respect, I'm going to visit her. Because every time we have celebrations, she's always there.
Because it's a lot cheaper And plus, the Philippines, not a whole lot of room either. But my grandparents did a closed casket, and I thank them for that reason. Because I want to remember them when they were alive, not them laying there. That's the best way to remember somebody. Closed casket. You don't need to see them when they're dead. Because then you're going to have that in your memory. At first, I didn't like my granddad because it was closed casket when my grandma Moore died. But then as I got older, I appreciated it. Because then I understood why. I got to go back out to my truck again.
Yeah, I'll just wait for you.
No, I could still talk. I can leave my headset on. I can walk around, just not too far.
Okay. Who's singing?
She's got some girl on her panel. I don't know who it is.
Okay.
It looks like she stepped away from her computer. I was there. I asked Rosalie. Rosalie, if I come up there, what do you want to hear? Because I got a very...
Just for you, I'm not going to mention who is that.
Yeah, I got a very broad catalog, and I'm trying to expand it more and more. Because I think folks get tired of hearing the same songs karaoke. So I'm like, I'm going to keep changing it up, keep doing different ones. Unless they request.
Me, I'm going to sing only those fit on my voice, but I'm not going to sing what J. Mike said to me. Please sing this song. Come on. Alanis Morissette. Yeah, that one that he requested to me, I'm not going to try it because it's quite complicated on my voice. I have to shout on that, you know.
Yeah, I've been trying to get all the girls. Like, I tried to get Blessed Life to do it. She never really gave me an answer.
Yeah.
Trying to get them to do the song by the Divinals.
But remember that Bob is watching.
Yeah, but I asked this over a year ago.
Okay.
She didn't say yes or no. It was that song, I Touch Myself, by the Divinals. Hey, that's a cool tune. And if a dude doesn't like the song, that means they're gay. That's obvious.
You know what? We do like your voice, John. This is the reason why she is inviting you on the live stream.
Oh, Blessed?
Yeah.
Ooh, who's that, Panay? Math teacher divine. Here, let me show you the.
I don't see? Know. That is a Tim Rockista.
Very beautiful, Panay. Unless you used a filter to get rid of a lot of wrinkles and, you know, moles or whatever.
What about the other one, the one you crushed? Still, I'm not, don't mention names, okay?
I'm sorry?
I mean the one that you crushed. You know her. No mentioning names.
Well, this is Rosalie's channel that I'm watching on my laptop. And I never seen this woman before. It says Math Teacher Divine. I don't know if that's her name. But they never turn their cameras on.
I don't know. She is, I think, in other countries.
Yeah, when you have family members that pass away, you want to remember the good times and the bad and the times when they were alive, not them laying there in the casket.
Yeah. too.
That's why I love the people from Louisiana. They have a big celebration, a barbecue, and everything. They're like, they're happy. Yeah. And I'm like, you know, everybody is saddened and everything like that. No. Like if I pass away, I told my friends long ago, look, if I pass away, y'all know what I want, because I'm going to tell you right now. Make it a barbecue. Everybody have a good time. Because
you're saying those words, you're not going to die.
Yeah, well, I'm saying that, you know, everybody have a good time. Let's say, make it a barbecue. Everybody have a good time, because, hey, I want some dudes to start talking. They'd be like, hey, you remember Sean's funeral? Man, I met this girl and got laid and did all this stuff. I had a great time at Sean's funeral. That's the kind of memories I want to leave them.
Yeah, that'll be fine. Oh, what yeah. Leonard said. They celebrate their life.
Yeah.
Leonard, you can come up in the panel if you like.
Yeah, Leonard usually does.
Maybe he's not feeling well.
This woman's a good singer. She sounds like she sings at a church choir.
Yeah.
But where the hell is everybody?
Well, some of them, they're tired. Or some of them, they went out. It's Friday night in the Philippines.
Yeah, but they're not going to get lucky. Come back on here in the live stream.
Why?
You're not going to score any strikes sitting there, are you? Just come on home and log in.
Oh, I found out there's a one YouTuber. He was hacked. I don't know what's going on in YouTube, why they're hacking another YouTuber.
If they do that, that means they're going to destroy it.
Yeah.
Shear?
Yes?
I'm going to switch over to my laptop, okay?
Okay.
Okay, you're going to see me in... You're going to see me pop up in the back... And I'm gonna log off here, okay?
Okay, no problem. I'll wait for you.
Hi, hey everybody.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, nice background, Sean.
Yeah.
Why is my other thing up?
I don't know. We got you twice now.
Yeah, let me.
There you go.
I'm gone.
Yeah.
This one is good. Yeah, Conway is going to practice his song piece for tomorrow in this life.
Tonight for us, Westerners.
Yes.
Yeah, tonight.
Hey, you ought to come in there, Leonard.
What's that?
Westlife live stream. It's going to be tonight for us.
Yeah. I try to catch her pretty often.
Shear, what time?
That will be around the. It depends. Sometimes she is around 7:30 in the morning in the Philippines. Normally it's around 7 she started.
Okay, that'd be 5 here.
It'll be 6. You're in Central Time?
Yeah, I'm in Central Time. Maybe 5 p.m. here.
You're in Houston?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm in Central Time. I'm in Springfield, Missouri.
Oh, yeah.
So it'll be 5 o'clock this afternoon today.
Yep.
I'm excited to hear Sean singing.
That's always good.
Yeah.
I do that one song from Foreigner, but I mostly, when I come to people's panels now, I just leave this up because it's an irony. They call us foreigners, so I was a foreigner.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you said that in another live I saw you on.
I mean, when they look at it, they should laugh.
Yeah.
You can sing as many songs as you like. So tomorrow, get ready. And a lot of girls will look after. Oh, is that John?
Sheer, when you hear me talk, do I have an echo behind my voice, a stereo sound voice?
A little, but it's natural, you know.
You hear it a little bit, okay.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't showing up when I'd go back and watch some of the live streams that I was on. I'm like, okay. I'm not hearing the echo, but it sounds great on my headset. I just wish you could hear the way I'm hearing.
Yeah, but your sound is great too. It's no problem.
Well, I spent almost $400 on these Bose headsets.
And wow.
Yeah, they do. Everybody sounds great through my head.
So now, get ready. What's your next song? We are so excited to hear this baritone voice. type of negative.
Okay, so give me a minute. You're going to hear silence.
Okay.
I got to reset my K1.
Sorry, guys. One of my co-hosts will sing.
Do you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay.
Let me know if you're going to sing so I can be muted.
The Chicago Blackhawks, my favorite NHL hockey team.
So, Sean, let me know if you're going to sing. So, guys, this is what I'm doing. I'm trying to edit this artwork. I already did this long time ago. But now I'm coming back to edit it using colored pencil. Leonard, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. Just got a sore neck.
Ah, did you put something like a menthol in your, or like a salon pass?
Yeah, I got to see if I have any. I might have some. Mm-hmm. Salon pass.
Yeah.
That would probably help.
Yes.
Either that or I need a chiropractor.
Yeah.
What's
Sean is fixing something.
Yeah.
Nah.
Sean, have you ever sang Ghost Riders?
Something tells me I should know that, but
it's a Western song. But I think your voice would be wonderful on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, the country never grabbed me by the ass like rock and roll and metal did.
That's yeah. Yeah, I used to hear it sung by a rock band and it was just awesome. But let's see, Johnny Cash did it. I don't remember if Waylon did it or not, but Marty Robbins did it. Huh?
Waylon Jennings was always my favorite. He's the only country music star that I can listen to his music all day long. It wouldn't bother me.
Yeah, that's the way I feel about him too. Him and Marty Robbins. But they both did it. And I just think your voice would work real well with it, but yeah, what do I know?
Waylon Jennings had a very distinct voice. See, back in the day, Cher, back in the 70s and 80s, when you heard country music singer sing, you knew immediately who it was because they all had distinctive voices. Now they all sound alike.
Yeah.
Very true.
Honestly, you're getting confused. You know, I didn't know that Stick, his voice is the same with Freddie Mercury. Honestly. The lead vocalist.
Yeah, Freddie Mercury and Dennis DeYoung from Styx, they did sound alike.
Yes, they have the same voice.
Yeah.
How old is that guy? He's still alive?
Dennis DeYoung?
Yeah.
It's just he can't get along with the guys from Styx. He does his own thing and Styx does their own. But if it wasn't for Dennis DeYoung, they wouldn't have half the hits that they have.
It happens most of the time in the band. They need to separate each other, you know?
Well, it's an ego thing.
Okay. I used to have a band before. I was one of the members. But since one of the members died, it doesn't work anymore.
Oh, yeah. That messed things up.
Or sometimes if one of the member is becoming, you know, the ego is starting to rise up, that's not good.
No, that's what usually happens.
Yeah. I made friends with somebody that creates karaoke songs. He takes the actual song and he edits it, or he tries cutting this out, the audio out, and all this. I don't know how he does it, but he sent me this a couple hours ago, and I'm like, I gotta give this a shot. Now, I'm going into this. I'm sorry?
You can sing it now.
Okay.
Okay, we'll be mute now.
Oh, hang on a second, Cher. I need you for it. Now, do you hear an echo?
Yeah, there's
a lot of echo?
No, just a little.
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. What about now?
There's more.
Okay. There we go. I'm good. There's not a lot of people in here, so I can give this a shot. This is going to tell you a story. I'm going to use her background. This is a song by Ted Nugent. It's Motor City Mayhem, and this is called The Great White Buffalo. And it's a live version that he edited for me. I don't know how it's going to work out, but I give it a good shot.
Yes, and the Great White Buffalo! Yes! Listen, everybody, yeah, to what I got to say. There's hope for tomorrow, yes, it's if you wake up today. It happened long ago in the new magic land. The Indian and the buffalo, they existed hand in hand. The Indian needed food, he needed skins for a roof. But he only took what he needed. Millions of buffalo were the proof. Millions of buffalo on the prairies of Oklahoma. Yeah! Buffalo. And then came the white man with his thick and empty head. He couldn't see past the field flow. He wanted all the buffalo dead. Geronimo, Crazy Horse, Sitting Bull, Coaches, Red Cloud.
Oh, this kicks ass. Oh, shit. It just cut out on me.
What happened? Hello, Pretty Annie.
It ended.
That was going so good.
Yeah,
you have a great voice.
I've been wanting to do that. I used to perform it live.
Yeah.
You have a great voice, John.
I gotta say, that was, the upload didn't come all the way through. Is what?
Yeah.
I got
that was
excited.
One of Nugent's best songs too.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's part Harani and Indian.
I did not know that.
Yeah, a lot of people.
You mean Farsi? They call it Farsi.
Yeah,
so Iranian Indian.
Well, it's around New York and Michigan and that northern area right around the lakes.
Yeah,
and a lot of people that live up there. A bunch of them were descended from them too.
Yeah, he's from Detroit, so.
Oh yeah, Redford. If you count all the big stars that came out of Detroit, it's insane. Madonna,
yeah.
Bob Seger. I mean, there was a bunch.
I didn't realize Seger was from there, but.
Oh, yeah. He did that song, Let's All Go to Fire Lake. 3 years ago, I finally found it.
Ah.
I mean, there's an actual fire lake here? That's what Bob Seger was singing about.
Yeah. Cool.
It's between Detroit and Cadillac. It's in the middle of nowhere.
Oh, okay.
You can sing what you like.
Yeah, Kid Rock, Eminem, NSYNC, Clown Posse. There's a lot of people from the Detroit area.
Yeah.
What about you, Leonard? What kind of band do you like? What band do you like?
What bands do I like?
Yes.
Not many of the new ones, but I grew up listening to Fleetwood Mac and REO Speedwagon, the Beatles,
whoa,
Elvis Presley.
Yeah, my oldest sister Donna dated Bruce Hall back in the day before they became famous.
Yeah.
They dated for like almost a year and a half.
Wow.
That's how I got to know them. Cronin remembers me as an 8-year-old kid.
Probably wouldn't recognize you now.
No.
Because the 8-year-old turns out to be a giant.
But they remember you, though, because I talked to Bruce. I said, Bruce, you remember who I am? He goes, no, that was years ago. You're from Champaign area. I'm like, yeah, you dated my sister Donna. He was like, oh, Sean.
Well, that's cool.
Like, that's high.
Is that the one that was singing? the singer?
No, that's Kevin Cronin. Bruce is the bass player with the long blonde.
Ah, bass player, okay. What happened? Why is it it doesn't work with your sister and that guy?
I don't know what happened. I was a little kid. I was the
Hello, Nancy Quino. How you doing?
Hey, Nancy.
Yeah, he wrote one song, Bruce Hall did, that was a hit with REO. It was called Back on the Road Again.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah.
But, Leonard, did you know that? None of the REO Speedwagon band members are the original members.
No, I did not.
Oh, yeah.
All the originals were replaced, and when they got Cronin, Cronin brought Bruce Hall in because they were both students together. Most of them were students together there in the University of Illinois in Champaign.
Oh, okay.
And when Cronin brought Bruce Bruce Hall with him, that's when they started becoming famous because Cronin wrote some damn good songs. Their biggest hits were written by Cronin.
Yeah.
His voice
yeah,
is really
I had
good.
No idea that they had changed all the members around.
Yeah, none of them are original. That's what's funny about that band. And a lot of people don't know that. I mean, people that grew up watching them, you know, playing clubs and festivals and stuff, I know that.
Yeah.
You can practice more songs for tomorrow. We're excited.
Yeah. What was it, Leonard? 5 o'clock this afternoon?
Yes.
Okay. We have 5.5 hours.
Normally, Bless Life make it earlier because after that, she went out. She's going out.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'll probably be able to catch Lazy Larry Lee after her.
If I was there and I was her man, I'd be like, no, you ain't going out. We're going out.
Good.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm surprised some of the ladies, the Panays that sing a lot of rock songs, they don't do any Joan Jett. That surprises me. She's a legend.
That's right. I've never heard any.
We don't hear that that singer here in the Philippines. So
yeah, put another dime in the jukebox was the what put her on the map after yep. She left the Runaways. But her big one was I Hate Myself for Loving You.
Yeah.
That was a big
one. Yeah, we know that. We know that.
Yeah, I've not heard anyone sing it.
Normally I've heard that in the bar. There are some band members they used to sing that in the bar. In Manila.
Yeah.
Filipinas can sing that.
Yeah, they should be able to.
Yeah, they should be able to do the divinals. I touch myself.
Suggest that soon. If you come to the Philippines and you go to this place is good for bands, Cowboy Grill. You ask the band member there, do you know this one? Yeah. You can ask it or you can give them a tip. Okay, can you please sing this song for me? Or they will invite you to come up in the street.
Yeah, but that
Since
song...
Since you're a foreigner, you're welcome.
Yeah, that song is only meant for a female to sing, though.
Right.
Okay, sorry.
And she goes, I don't want anybody else. When I think about you, I touch myself. Oh.
I haven't heard that for a long time.
Yeah. They were from Australia.
Oh, God.
I'd like to hear Timmy sing that one.
Oh, I've been in many a clubs when a girl did karaoke that, and every dude in the place is watching.
Yeah. Yep.
Me, I only watch to see if they add the attitude behind it. And if they do, it's great. It's better when you add the attitude behind it.
Yeah.
Oh, Sean, are you going to sing?
Yeah, I just got to find. I'm just
okay.
Trying to figure out which one to do.
You can practice here. You're welcome.
Well, I fouled that Ted Nugent tune up.
Well, you didn't foul it up. It cut out on you, man.
Yes.
Well,
you're feeling it.
Anyway, Shear, if you didn't understand the lyrics, what tells the story of American history with the Indians? How they...
Okay.
Yeah, it was European cattle farmers. They brought their cattle. They didn't exist. And the Indians, the buffalo was such an abundance. If you were hungry, just go out there and get you a buffalo. Boom. You got meat for... If you're by yourself, that meat would last you for a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But see, the cattle farmers came here, and that's when they started to slaughter all the buffalo. They almost slaughtered them to an extinction. They're making a comeback, but it's slow.
What about the bison?
That's who he's talking about.
Yeah, the same thing. American buffalo.
Ah, the buffalo. I really like that.
They're bigger than your caribou. They're like twice as big.
They're big. They can be 7 feet tall at the shoulders.
Are they tamed? Are they tamed or they're wild?
They're wild in general, but there are some that have been tamed.
Yeah, there are some people like in Michigan that have a buffalo farm.
Yeah.
They behave just like normal cattle.
I used to haul hay to a buffalo farm. They're out of Coeur d'Alene.
Yeah, in the Philippines, if we have like that, you know, Filipino guys, they will kill it and they will use it this for a food while they're drinking. They will make it like a caldereta.
They get a lot of food off one of them if it was full grown. Yeah.
They didn't waste anything. The Indians didn't waste nothing. They skinned them and they used them to make teepees with.
Yeah.
Or clothing.
Yeah.
Did you eat also the bison, the cattle?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Use the bones to make jewelry and all this different things.
Yeah. Yeah, they used the complete total animal. And I know the army had a lot to do with it because they wanted to hurt the American Indians' livelihood so they would move out of the territories they were in, which made it for the ranchers.
Yeah, that's where the famous Buffalo Bill Cody comes into play.
Yeah.
He was famous for slaughtering a lot of buffalo. That's why he got the nickname Buffalo Bill Cody.
Yep.
Me, I would have been like, I'm not going to slaughter all these animals just to hurt these people. Plus, that's against laws of nature. I'm not going to do
that. Right. And the worst thing is they would kill them and cut the tongue out, maybe skin them, and leave the rest.
Oh.
So it would just go to waste. And it was just to cut out the food source for the Indians to make them leave the territory where they were because the army wanted to take it over for their own use.
Yeah, I've made a lot of people angry, Leonard, when I've been asked, when we talk about, economics and everything. They say, they think I hate America. No, I'm just critical of it. We could be so much better.
You're
and
just very honest.
Yeah, and they asked me, what was the greatest moment in American history? And I told them bluntly, I said, that's when Sitting Bull and Crazy Horse slaughtered the 7th Cavalry at Little Bighorn.
Yeah.
Because of what they did at Wounded Knee, that was despicable.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, the American Army did, cavalry and stuff, did way more bad things than the Indians ever thought of.
Yeah, they murdered a bunch of women and children and babies at Wounded Knee. They were unarmed, and they just slaughtered them.
Yep.
That's why that book, Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee.
Yes.
I consider that recommended reading.
Yeah. You know, Sean, all my life growing up, they always told us that we were part Indian. And they couldn't say what tribe or anything like that. So I've done a couple of different DNA tests. Ain't no American Indian in me at all.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Some Libyan.
Well, yeah, the only reason why I know it is because two of mine were Chippewas.
Yeah.
My grandparents were freaks. I wouldn't say that while they're alive, but look at it. It's like, you're German. You messed with this, you know, nice Chippewa lady here. And my
life. There's a lot of American Indian females, very beautiful.
Yeah, my granddad said the ladies couldn't resist the German sausage.
Oh my God!
Because the majority of your Germans that immigrated from Europe, they went to Wisconsin because it does. It looks like Germany.
Yeah. Oh, you know, Sean, I worked for about 6 months with a very close to full-bred Cherokee. And he was not as tall as you, but he was tall like you, and big like you. And he was a great guy. Man, we got along really good.
Yeah, I embraced my heritage. At first, I took it for granted, like it wasn't a big deal. But as I got older, I embraced it a lot more.
Yeah.
It took me a little bit longer, but I embraced my German and Irish side too. That's why I went to Germany and Ireland and everything.
Well, that was nice you were able to do that.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not fluent in either language. You know, I know a little bit here and a little bit there.
Yeah.
Do you know how to speak in an Indian language, John?
Yeah, but I'm not fluent. I have to be on the reservation for a while, and then it just comes to me.
Okay.
Because if you don't use something, you lose it. But if you use it,
that's like me in Spanish.
Yeah, like Sherry, you and Sammy have been on IT for 2 years. Go back to one of your first live streams, listen to yourself, and then listen to you now. Your English is dramatically improved, just like Sammy.
Yeah, absolutely. The more you use it, the better you get at it.
Yes.
And so
need to speak in English also because I've known someone that he cannot speak my own language, and I cannot speak also his language because he speaks Italian.
Yep. Sheer, I would consider you fluent. You still have the accent. Unlike Bless doesn't have the accent, and she's very fluent in English.
Right.
That's why when you listen to her and you don't see her, you would think that she was from the States.
Yep.
Yeah, but this is my second language only. So it's just like in Thailand. You cannot expect the people there to speak. They can be fluent in English, but they have always an accent of a Thai.
Sometimes sheer is, but Sammy's learned a lot of it, is the slang. That's what throws you off.
Yeah.
Well, maybe my accent is terrible, but this is the way I speak.
No, your accent's not terrible at all.
No, not at all. I've heard a whole lot worse.
Oh, yeah.
There's so many Filipinas, you know, their accent, normally Filipino. Cannot expect them, you know.
Oh, yeah. They got to speak it. Go ahead, Sean.
When they sing a song that's in English, they don't have any accent. They sound like a Westerner. When they talk, it's like, what happened?
Yeah. I noticed that back with the British singers in America, like the Beatles and can't remember who else, but anyway, you know, all of them, and they'd sing.
I have a question. If ever I sing, do I sound Filipino?
Sometimes, depending on the song.
Okay. But this is the way I am. Accept it, okay?
Hey, nobody's complaining. Hey, Warren, how you doing?
That triggers me every time. I keep trying to find something. Here comes a Panay in a bikini, and it's like, I don't need to look at that. Move it.
I lose your place.
Don't get me wrong. I enjoy seeing that, but at appropriate moments, just not now.
Right. It is distracting.
I remember when I collabed to Dead Parang. Dead Parang he's an Australian like blogger. I was singing, and then he told to the to the viewers that keep it on your mind in your mind. She's a Filipina, and that is her second language. Because he knows that there are some people, they used to criticize Filipinos' accent. But this is the way we are.
Well, I actually like it, so.
Who is this?
I'm going to mute for a second and check this song out. If it,
you know, okay. Okay, this is Warren RCG said. I've noticed that most Filipinas don't pronounce the TH in words when they sing.
Yes.
For example, that instead of that.
Yeah, he's right. He is right.
Yeah.
They just go with the T and forget the H. They just go tat.
Yeah.
Or dat, yeah.
Yeah. Keep it on your minds, guys. If the people from the province, they sing, sometimes, their accent will show up. You cannot avoid that.
Right.
As long as we can sing, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I get my clothes strained out here.
Okay. You know, I really appreciate that guy, Dead Parang. He never ever, criticized me so much. But I'm very happy. That's my first time to collab to a foreigner.
Oh wow, that's good.
Yeah, he is from Australia.
Yeah.
I don't talk to him too much now because I think he just stopped being a YouTuber now. For some reason.
Yeah. I agree with you, Warren. I love it.
Even Russians, you cannot avoid their accent. You can hear their accent.
Yeah, Russian, they got their accent no matter what they say or sing or whatever.
Yeah. I have a Russian friend from YouTube. You cannot avoid it.
Yeah. Yeah, I worked with a Russian guy, and he is a great guy, but he had that accent. I had to pay attention when he talked.
Russians, they're very cool guy. They're just like a Lithuanian, Estonian.
Yeah.
They're very friendly.
In general,
compared to other European,
In general, they're very good people.
Yes. Romanian also, they're nice people.
Yes. The few I've known have been.
Yeah, but before, when Tsar Nicholas still alive, these people, they're united in Russia. They're not separated yet to Russia.
Right.
It's just like a big change when, you know, the people doesn't like anymore the Tsar. Everybody, you know, they goes in the other ways, you know. They created their own group.
Yeah.
Leonard, thank you for coming here in my live stream. Man.
Thank you for having me. I always enjoy your live streams.
Yeah. Honestly speaking, my content is like this most of the time. And someone already commented on me that I should not show up what I'm doing because people will copy it. Well, so many people doing this, they're doing a drawing while they're live. You know?
Yeah, there are some.
But I really like this one, okay? Because this is more legit.
Yep.
I can show to people that I'm the one who was making it.
Right.
Yeah,
and you are very good, so that helps.
Sorry about lately, okay? What does Warren RCG said? I worked with a Russian years ago. She was great. She used to tell about secret parties just to, you know, listen to music when it was the USSR. Ah, okay.
Yeah, they had real strict regulations on all of that.
But, you know, Russia is booming now, you know, compared before when the Tsar is the one who was ruling. There's so many kids.
It's not booming so much now because of all the sanctions.
Yeah. Because of the leader.
They're actually going into financial problems.
The leader wants more.
He's being imperialistic.
That's not gonna be happened, you know. If before you can do it, like you can conquer another country, it's impossible right now.
Yeah, too many treaties and other countries backing up the one you're trying to conquer. And because right now he's basically, without the NATO people actually physically being involved, he's actually fighting all of NATO too. Because they're supplying the weapons. And they just decided to send a bunch of tanks, new modern tanks, that are better than what Russia has. So at least that's what they say. So hopefully it'll cause this war to come to an end in the desired way.
Italians, when they speak English, that is, oh my God. Sean, oh my God, I like the background.
It's nice.
I wanted to find the other one that they used in Columbus, Ohio. That one was really cool, but I can't find it. My ex has a t-shirt. I've seen this band many a time. I don't remember how many times as a kid, but when they became famous, I've only seen them 7 times. And almost every time I've seen them, either they opened up or Styx opened up for them. When you saw Styx, you were seeing REO Speedwagon. It's just the way it was. Those two bands toured together. Waiting for the cleaning lady to come by. And I don't call me weird, but they like coming into my room because there's not much to clean up because I sleep on top of the blankets. The only time I get in is if it's really cold. Basically, I don't get under the blankets at all.
Yeah, that makes it easy on them.
And they asked me, didn't you sleep? I said, yeah, I just sleep on top of the blankets. Nice and warm in here. I don't need a blanket.
Yeah.
But when it got to minus 20 that one time last year, oh, yeah, I got under the blankets because even
I'll
the
bet.
Barely keeping up.
Yeah, I'll bet.
All right, I'm going to try this REO Speedwagon song.
Yay.
Should Thanks be good. Continue.
It's not what you think, though, Sheer. This was one of my favorites by them. Here we go. I got to switch this here. And I got to switch the audio here. Whoops. There we go. I think I got it now. Okay. Here we go. Whoops.
Storm out, waiting for the thaw out, on a full moon night in a Rocky Mountain winter. My wine bottles are low, waiting for the snow. I've been thinking lately of what I've been missing in the city, and I'm not missing a thing. Watching the full moon cross through the range, riding the storm out, riding the storm out, riding the storm out, riding the storm out. Ladies beside me, she's there to guide me. She says, I'm alone. Found my home. The wind outside is frightening, but it's kinder than the light of life in the city. And it's harder life to live with what you give. And I'm not missing a thing, watching the full moon cross through the range, riding the storm out, right in the storm out, right in the storm out, right in the storm out. fallout on a full moon night in a Rocky Mountain winter. My wine bottle's low, waiting for the snow. I've been thinking lately of what I've been missing in the city, and I'm not missing a thing. Watching the full moon cross through the range, right in the storm out, right in the storm out, right in the storm out, right in, right in, right in the storm out.
Nice.
See, I had to go back by memory. I had to worry about the timing. It's just listening to this most of my life. That's how I know it. But the timing would be off. That's what I was worried about because there was no lyrics. I had it memorized.
You have an amazing voice.
Yeah, but I'm no Cronin, though.
Yeah, I've noticed that with a lot of the karaoke stuff. The timing isn't what it ought to be. You know, I always go too fast.
Yeah, I like to take a step down. If you got a karaoke machine, you can do that. And a lot of us, when we played in bands, you always take a step down. It's slower.
Yeah.
Because they do that because of time. So they shorten songs up by speeding them up a little bit where it's barely noticeable to the trained ear.
Yeah.
Musicians immediately notice it. That's why this person sounds different. It has a little deeper of a voice than when you hear it on the recording. That's because they speed it up.
Yeah. Yeah, but I what I mean is like when I try to sing to practice, I try to sing a song that I've heard my whole life and I know the tempo and the speed the words should be. And I'm always too fast.
Yeah, because you're used to hearing the recording. That's why I like live music better.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with that. But yeah, that is true. I am used to listening to the recordings.
You have an amazing voice, John.
Yeah, but my voice is more in tune to like Gene Simmons from Kiss, Queensryche, Jeff Tate, and Peter Steele from Type O Negative. That's why the algorithm can't tell the difference. And it dings me with copyright.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, speaking of copyright, I uploaded something on my other TikTok, okay? It was I was holding my my bird, and guess what? I put the hashtag about parrot, and then suddenly when I opened again my TikTok, it was my video was gone, and they said that I violated a rules. I'm holding only the parrot. How come it was violated?
I found out haters
doing it, complaining for no reason.
Was that the one with the bow tie?
No. It was in TikTok. I was playing my, what they call this? I'm teasing my two birds, which is the African lovebird and the cockatiel.
Oh, yeah. I didn't see that one.
Yeah. The you know, the TikTok removed it, and they said that I violated the rules.
What, the birds are copyrighted?
No, it's just like there are some haters, whenever they found out you have a video, they will complain for nothing. And this is the reason why I dispute. I said, I don't copy anyone. This is my birds. Yeah. So let's see what will happen soon.
Sean Tuber, he always has Sonny in his videos. I'm surprised he hasn't gotten...
Yeah, I know. But you know what happened, right? That I'm defending Darren. And there are some the trolls there. If they found out I have a TikTok, they will complain for nothing.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like you're abusing the animals. You can pretty much well tell these birds are...
Yeah, there's an explanation. I don't know. Maybe this person has no... what we call this, doesn't understand English. There's a translation. There's also a person who was speaking. But I'm not the one who was speaking. It was the computer generated in a Google.
Uh-huh.
Well, whatever I write over there in English, the Google is speaking, is talking. And I got a violation. I don't know. I don't understand what kind of violation that they're talking about. So I just speak.
Sheer, give me a second. I got to empty my trash can.
Okay. I can wait for you.
Because there's a bigger trash can outside. I can just empty mine out in because the ladies are probably still in the other rooms. I'll be right back.
Yeah. Well, Sam Chronicles is here. How you doing? Yeah, you can come up if you like. I'll just invite again. Post again the... Call this sorry, Leonard. I'll post
no problem
on the stream yard. Yeah,
yeah, no problem. It's your stream, you post whatever you want.
Yeah, I know, but I think I'll sing one song for you guys, okay? So, I always depending on Sean, and it's about time it's my turn. But at first, I'm going to open first my Bluetooth if I'm going to connect. I hope it will connect. Now it's connected.
Yes.
I'll sing one song for you guys. Sorry about my accent.
Ah, we love it.
I'm a Filipina. Actually, right now, since one of my aunties passed away, that's the cousin of my mother. I'm not allowed, you know, to be so much happy, okay?
Well,
but I'm going to sing this one song. Hold on. This one. You're still the one, okay? I'll sing this one.
Oh, that's a good song.
When I first saw you, I saw love. And the first time you touched me, I felt love. And after all this time, you're still the one that I love. Ooh, yeah, looks like we made it. Look how far we've come, my baby. We might took the long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together and going strong. You're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. You're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one I kiss good night. ain't nothing better. We beat the odds together. I'm glad we didn't listen. Look at what we won't be missing. They said, I bet they'll never make it. Just look at us holding on. We're still together and going strong. You're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. Oh yeah, you're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one I kiss good night. You're still the one. Make a love shout out to Sam Chronicles and to everyone. Yeah, you're still the one that I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one that I want for life. Oh yeah, you're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one that kiss goodnight. Looks like we made it. Look how far we've come, my baby. Thank you, guys. John, it's your turn.
I gotta go use the restroom. I'll be right back.
Okay. Thank you, Sam. Would you like to come up in the panel and join with us? I already dropped the StreamYard link. Thank you, guys. Now I'm going to continue my art session here. I have to finish this because someone owns this already. And I promised to this person that I'm going to send it this January, but I've not yet I have no time for for editing it or retouching it using a colored pencil. Are you in the bed? It's all right. How is your channel now? Lately I was in the live stream of Jack. You're talking about someone is hacking you. And even in my Facebook, you're not around anymore. What's wrong? What's happening? You blocked me in the messenger. I got it back. Yes, I was hacked on YouTube and FB. Okay, that's good. But I lost FB. What? What happened? Did you report that? The person who trying to hack you? Why is it this hacking? Leonard, are you there? I think he's busy.
No, I'm here.
Yeah, I read the message of Sam. He was hacked, and even his Facebook was gone. I hope soon, if you're trying to get back in FB, try to add me again.
Yeah, I had that same thing happen. I didn't have YouTube blocked, but I had I was hacked in Facebook, actually twice. And I had to get that. I got that all straightened out finally. But it seems to happen a lot.
Did you find out who did that to you, Leonard?
I never got the actual name, but I don't even know if it was him. Because I never had a picture on my Facebook page of me. And yeah. A friend told me that someone had messaged her on Facebook, and it was a picture of somebody she didn't know. And so I checked it out. And I was able to, yeah. Then I had to put my picture up.
You know what? I have a special, I hope there is some Africans watching here or some Nigerians watching here, okay? Guys, if you don't like to be discriminated, don't do this, you know, to the white people or to some Asian people, you know? Trying to invading the social media and grabbing their photos without any consent. What's wrong with you guys? That's not right. And you cannot hide yourself in using others' pictures, you know, because the truth is always revealed.
Yeah.
And I've watched in Catfish a lot of American girls was fooled by this, you know, this Africans, this Nigerian scammers. And, you know, the emotional that you cause from these people, you know, they're working hard for their money. And there you are, you keep on asking and pretending to be someone that you are not. That's why, you know what, I've been victimized before about that. Long time ago when I was, I met a person from TAG. He was pretending to be American guy, a U.S. Army guy. And you know what? I don't believe in it. First of all, I was looking on the guy. I said, this picture is already old. So I was thinking maybe this guy's already dead and this person is trying to grab this profile. And the worst thing, this guy sent me a receipt. Please claim this my package from the airport because this is the receipt. I'm not stupid. I zoom it, that receipt. You know what I found out? It was tampered. So this guy is a scammer. And good thing I asked his number because he was pretending to be he's in Nigeria, but he is American. And I found out that the profile picture, I think he a 20-year-old guy, a black guy. You know, I messaged him. Oh, black is beautiful. How come you're hiding yourself in the white guy? And then he said, what are you talking about? No, you're fooling me. And then I blocked that guy. That's it.
Yeah. I've had several women claim to be in the military, but upon asking them some questions, now I was not in the military, but I know enough people who were. Yeah. So I could ask them legitimate questions and they couldn't answer right. They come up with BS stuff. And it was all about trying to get money.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, even the profile of the gays, they're trying to hack it.
Yep.
Try to watch that, the Scamfish channel, and also Trilogy Media. The Trilogy Media is so funny because the one who was running it is Ashton and Art. Art is from Russia. So his accent is Russian, but he speaks English, but they're very good when it comes to investigating and caughting this Nigerian scammers and the people from Ghana also.
Yeah.
I'm not racist, but don't do it. You know, yes. I will tell you something. There are some Africans are not allowed in Europe, especially somewhere in Scandinavia. Because one of my friends got married to a African girl. He wanted to, you know, to bring the wife in his country. The thing is, his country doesn't like to accept that woman in their country.
Yeah.
So my friend's wife needs to live in the other part of the Europe. But I'm not going to reveal their names because, first of all, they are not YouTubers.
Well, yeah, there's no reason to.
Yeah.
It's none of our business.
Yeah, you see, guys, if you did bad things to other people, it will backfire to you. So I think they must stop grabbing photos and pretending to be someone just to get some money. Because these people is also working for their money. They have skills, you know. They know how the computer. They can use it in a better way. John, do you like to sing?
You're muted, searching. Sean. Oh, there you go.
Searching.
It's 4 a.m. here.
Well, take care, Sam.
Yeah, I understand, Sam. Don't worry. So good night, because it's night now in Australia.
Something wrong with my cup.
Okay.
It's empty.
So when are you going to the Philippines?
Well, I was planning on going in February, but that got squashed. So it's probably going to be July or maybe August.
Okay.
We'll just have to see how money works out.
Okay. Good luck, huh?
No, thank you very much.
If there's a problem, you can call me. You know my number.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
I will definitely keep that in mind. I was planning to fly to Manila and then maybe meet you and Valmariz.
You can meet also Pinas Habit if you like.
Who's that?
Pinas Habit. Do you know her? In Best Life, you know her also.
Yeah, yeah. Are they all there in Manila?
Yeah, we're from Manila.
Okay. Yeah, well, that's great. That'd be wonderful.
I thought Bless lived in Makati.
Yeah, we are all in Metro Manila. I'm from Manila. Bless Life is from Makati. No, I think she's from Mandaluyong, here in Makati. And Pinas Habit is from, I think, from Valenzuela, part of Manila.
That sounds right. Yeah, it's all Manila's big. They're all suburbs, kind of like.
Yeah,
but it's all called Metro Manila.
Right.
Yeah, Metro Manila. So let's hear the beautiful voice of Sean Moore.
Well, I don't overly do it with the Queensryche, but I'll do a tune by them.
Yeah, practice. So by tomorrow, who knows?
I think you might enjoy this. I think I did it like once before, and I'll give it another shot. This is called Another Rainy Night. When you hear this song and you go back and listen to it on YT, see if you can see that they sound similar. Don't slam the door on your way out. Don't leave without saying goodbye. Another long distance night alone. You leave me wanting, always leave me wanting more. Last word today, you're coming home to stay. Wouldn't that be nice for a while? But now my takeout food is growing cold, and the candle's been a hole in the floor, and I'm still waiting for the ring on the phone. I'm alone without you. Yes, I'm
the light on for you. It's just another rainy night without you. There's a fog horn blowing from the coast tonight. Remember making love in the rain. Strange how laughter looks like crying with no sound. Raindrops taste like tears without the pain. I'm not much without you. I can't leave if I wanted to. Maybe that's why you stay around. But tonight I'll sit here tending the fire and pace the floor 100 times in an hour. And check the voice, now for the message you call. I'm alone without you. I know I said it before, I hate the sound of a closing door and your footsteps walking away. And I got those burn a hole in the floor, and I'm still waiting for the ring of the floor. I'm alone without you.
Oh my God!
Yeah, I never did the Queensryche tribute band. I tried to, but a lot of musicians just didn't know how to play their music.
All right.
That was good.
You have a wonderful voice.
Well, that's what started me karaoke. I was on vacation. This was like 20 years ago. Yeah. I was driving down to Florida from Ohio. And my wife at the time was asleep, and she woke up, and I was singing along to Queensryche. She goes, "You sound just like him." And then I got
with
my sister, and her husband loved karaoke, and they go out every weekend. And I went with them, and I did it for the first time. And these ladies come up to me, "You sound like Jeff Tate." I'm like, "I appreciate that. I really can't tell. You really can't hear yourself like everybody else can."
Right.
Yeah. Wow.
But see, I did a Queensryche tune in the Mall of Asia. The first one I did there that day was by Queensryche. It was called Silent Lucidity. And every time, you know, when I was there, everybody's standing in front of this screen and they're singing along and they got a big screen behind you. Mm-hmm. I'm the only one that walked up there. I grabbed the monitor. It was on wheels and I just pushed it out of the way because I didn't need it. And I wanted to engage the crowd as I sang. And before I did, I said, you know, people hear music differently and they have different ways of interpreting it. And, you know, you may not be going through the same thing that I'm talking about in the song, but maybe you go through it several years later. Mm-hmm. And that's why they were looking at the screen behind me reading the lyrics. After the first verse, they started to understand what the song was about. And before it ended, every woman in the place was crying. And I was like,
oh my God.
Reaction I was expecting, but that's what I got. But they loved it. And the woman that hosted the show, Maleng Dembuhay, came up and she put her arm around me. I've got the small panay right here. She goes, she was crying too. I'm like, yeah, I'll do another tune. I would have stayed up there all day if they wanted me to. And she had asked me, would you like to come on the show? I had no clue what she was about or anything. And I'm like, we'll be gone by then. Or I would have been on the show. And if that happened, my popularity probably would have went through the roof. But the songs I did at the Mall of Asia was recorded by a lot of phones and it went viral. Not on the internet per se, but everybody was sharing it with their friends. They were sending it to this person. That's why when people would look and stare at me, they'd point and then they'd look at their phone, and I figured out, well, that's when I learned that, you know, I got pretty popular by default because of that.
Nice, John. Keep on singing. Yeah. You have any song? Oh, who's this? Warren RCG likes it, your song, the way you sing.
Thank you, Warren.
So, do you have any song that you can practice with for tomorrow, for late, for tonight?
I'm going to tease Blessed Life. I'm not going to give it to her right away.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to try another Queensryche tune.
Okay. Go on.
I've never tried this one before. I'm going to try this one. It's another song by Queensryche, and it's tough. Yeah. It's kind of difficult for me because Jeff Tate has range, and I sound like him, but he can go much higher than I can sometimes, and I can't. And I'll give this one a shot. It's called Eyes of a Stranger. Operation Mindcrime.
Of what we had and what we knew. Every time I try to leave it behind me, I see something that reminds me of you. Every night the dreams return to haunt me, a rosary wrapped around your throat. I lie awake and sweat and pray to fall asleep. I see your face looking back at me. Looking back at me. And I raise my head and stare into the eyes of a stranger. Straight jacket memories, sanded advice.
no happy ending like there's always promised. There's got to be something left for me. And I raise my head and stare into the eyes of a stranger. I've always known that the mirror never lies. People always turn away from the eyes of a stranger. Lies behind my stare.
Wow, Sean.
Yeah, that could be
sung. You're the star.
That could be sung so much better, but I can't hit as high as.
Sir, connect in Messenger, Sam and Andrews. Okay, I'll do it later, okay? I'll do it later. Okay, so do you want to sing another song? So you can practice. You're the star now here in my live stream.
Yeah, I'm going to look at one here. It's a duet, but I just want to attempt it because I never attempted this before.
Okay.
If they have a version of it.
Yeah.
Crap. That's a good tune too. Some of your religious folks got pissed off about it. Catholics, they really didn't. It didn't bother them as much.
Okay.
It wasn't such a big deal about religious songs, but what the meaning behind it was, the original name of the band was going to be called The Mob, but I don't remember how actually it got changed to Queensryche, but that was the name of their first hit song, was Queen of the Reich. And, but see, Jeff Tate's Catholic too. And he was stating about what it's like to fall in love with a nun, have a big crush on a nun, because he had one. And he wrote a song about it, and a bunch of religious people went nuts over it. It's called Sweet Sister Mary. And it's a duet, and it's really good, if I can find one here.
So I already, Sam Chronicles, I already messaged you. Check your messenger. I already did it. So, is there any next song, Sean?
Yeah.
Or do you want the rest?
No, I'm looking for it.
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna have to use this one. Hang on one second. I gotta type something in here. Anyway, it tells a story about this guy that worked that was did low jobs for the mob, and the person that committed that was part of the mob witnessed the murder of a priest, he witnessed a murder of some sort, and he confessed to a priest before he died, and a nun witnessed it, and he was ordered to kill Mary and then kill the priest as well. But he was in love with the nun. That was a problem. Okay, this doesn't come with lyrics, so I'm worried about my timing on this. I'm gonna give it a shot. Whoops. Hold on one second here. I gotta switch all this around. That's what I like about Queensryche's music. It tells stories. All right. Let me rewind that a little bit. Okay, here we go.
Feel the rain coming down. My face feels the wet, my mind the storm. Flashing lights as people race to find shelter from the pour. Moving silent through the streets, the mine. Sings praises in the hall. The saintly faces, hallowed be their names, she can't recall. Sister Mary, Virgin Mary, silent with her sin. She fills me, I can taste her breath when she speaks. Come in.
I need a woman for this part.
Thank you.
Mary, Mary, just a hope in the underground. Thought you'd been them fooled, now they sent me for you. You know too much for your own good. Don't offer me faith, I've got all you need here. What I need is trust to keep us both alive. Help us make it through the night. Gotta pay by my arms and feed my mind.
This is the girl's part.
Only peace I've ever known. I close my eyes and you shoot. No, Mary, listen, you got to pull your strength. Your precious cost is gone. It made me wait so long. What we gave to everyone. The priest is cold and dead. On his knees he fell. The holy water's red. And he died, he said. Thank you, I've just watched him bleed. The clothing lips of the stain. Sweaty hands like fire and flame. Spread the sacrificial rite. The heart that altar burns my flesh. One heart tonight. Mary, my lady of pain. Always alone. Blind your search for the truth.
This can't be done without a female. The timing gets off and confusing. But it's a hell of a tune, though. If you want to listen to it, you know, type in, you know, Queensryche, Sweet Sister Mary on YT and listen to it, the duet. It's really good, especially live. Are you guys still here? I did that all alone, Jesus. Is there anybody in chat that can acknowledge me that hears me? Hello. Oh boy.
Hey, sorry, yeah. Guys. I just went to went upstairs, you know.
Yeah, I can't do it without a female to do it, the duet. The timing just—it's
yeah.
But it was not bad of an attempt on that one, Sweet Sister Mary.
You have a nice voice. I like your texture of your voice. Yeah. What happened now to Leonard? Are you there?
think he's doing something.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think there's anybody really doing live streams right now.
Yeah, it is.
I'm just trying to hang on long enough for Blessed Life.
All right.
Because that's going to be a long live stream. I could outlast anybody. Mm-hmm. With that.
Yeah. But did you attend it also to the live stream of Our Life in Our World or to Chite?
No, because they haven't done any live streams.
Yeah, because the time they become live, that's the time that you're sleeping too. Or you're busy. Yeah. So I think I'll sing a one song here. Hold on. I'll just search which song that I'm going to sing. But I'm going to try. I hope I can sing this Alanis Morissette, okay? I hope I can I can sing this. All right, where is it? I wanted to sing this Hand in My Pocket by Alanis Morissette. Okay, there you go. I'm broke, but I'm happy. I'm poor, but I'm kind. I'm short, but I'm healthy, yeah. I'm high, but I'm grounded. I'm sane, but I'm overwhelmed. I'm lost, and I'm hopeful, baby. This water's also gone down to... Oh, I cannot sing this one. It's too high. Sorry. Sorry, guys. I'm just tripping here, okay?
Well, didn't you just come down from a cold?
Huh?
I thought you had a cold.
No, I don't have a cold, but there's something wrong with my voice. Okay, hold on. I'll sing the other one instead. Because this one is too high for me. Hold on. I've seen this already. Or this one by, where is it? I've seen it already. Oh, here. Sorry about my voice, okay? I don't have a cold. Yeah. An old man turned 98. He won lottery and died the next day. And it's black fly in your Chardonnay. It's a death row part on two. Then it's too late. Isn't it ironic? Don't you think? It's like rain on a wedding day. It's a free ride when you already paid. It's a good advice that you just didn't take. And who would have thought it figures? It is plain to say, was afraid to fly. He packed his suitcase and the kids goodbye. And in a whole damn line, take that flight. And the plane crashed down. He thought, what is this? Isn't it ironic? Don't you think?
It's like rain on a wedding day. It's a free ride when you're already paid. It's a good advice that you just didn't take. And who would have thought it figures? Well, that's a funny way of sneaking it up on you when you think that everything goes fine. And life is a funny way of helping you out when you think it's everything gone wrong and everything blowing up in your face. A traffic jam when you're already late. A smoking sign on your cigarette break. And the 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife. And drinking mandarins and meeting a beautiful wife. Isn't it ironic? Don't you think? A little too ironic. And yeah, I really do think. It's like rain on a wedding day. It's a free ride when you're already paid. It's a good advice when you just didn't take. And who would have thought figures? Well, like it's a funny way sticking up on you. And like it's a funny, funny way of helping you out. Helping you out. Thank you, guys. Sorry, I messed up the other song. So, John, it's your turn.
Yeah, okay. I'll try this one. I think I did this once before long ago and then gave up on it, but I'll do it again. It's by Rob Zombie, but it's a remake of an old song. Leonard knows who it is and who it's by. I don't remember the original. Here it is.
When I grow up, I want to be a rock star.
For 40 days. Last night in Little Rock put me in a haze. Sweet, sweet Connie was doing all right. She had the whole show, and that's a natural fact. Up all night with Carrie Kane. I gotta tell you, poker is his thing. The booze and ladies keep me right. As long as we can make it to the show tonight, we're an American band. We're an American band. Now we're coming to your town. We'll help you party down. We're an American band. Hey, hey, hey.
There's also an Amish version of this song too.
Loyola Chiquitas in Omaha was waiting for the band to return from the show. Feeling good, feeling right, it's Saturday night. The hotel detective, he was out of sight. Yeah, now these fine ladies, they had a plan. They was out to meet the boys in the band. They said, come on dudes, let's get it on. And we proceeded to tear that hotel down. We're an American band. We're an American band. We
we're coming to your town. We'll help you party down. We're an American band. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're an American band. We're an American band. We're coming to your town. We'll help you party down. We're an American band. We're an American band. We're an American band. We're coming to your town. We'll help you party down. We're an American band.
I like the Amish version. It goes,
we're
an Amish band. We'll come to your farm. We'll help you build a barn. We are an Amish band.
Okay. Sing another song, Sean, Mr. Sean Moore. Stop trucking with beans.
I gotta find something here.
Yeah, Warren RCP says he likes it.
I just see a bunch of hands.
Yeah, but they're clapping. That means they appreciate your song. You see, you have an amazing voice.
I didn't know that that's what that emoji meant. Yeah, there's a bunch of songs I'd like to do, but there's no versions of it on karaoke yet.
All right.
That's why some of these guys that create it do a good job of it.
Okay, Sean will sing again for us.
Yeah, I'm going to give a slow one here. I got one.
Yeah.
Let me mute to make sure there's no commercials.
Okay.
Yeah, I did. I karaoke'd one time in Japan, and this is one of the songs I did, and the girls liked it. But I guess the majority of them didn't speak English. They knew the song, but they just didn't speak English. Okay, let me try that there. Okay. This one's going to be by Whitesnake. I know that's very popular over there in Japan, too.
By my side to tell me it's all
alright, cause I don't think I can take anymore. Is this love that I'm feeling? Is this the love that I've been searching for? Is this love, or am I dreaming? This must be love, cause it's really got a hold on me. A hold on. Stop the feeling, I've been this way before. With you I'd found the key to open any door. I can feel my love for you growing stronger day by day, and I can't wait to see you again, so I can hold you in my arms. Is this love that I'm feeling? Is this the love that I've been searching for? Is this love, or am I dreaming? This must be love, cause it's really got a hold on me. A hold on me.
This is a nice song, okay? I'll sing another song for you guys, okay? Something like this one. Where is it? Where is it? There you go, sir. Okay, I'll sing this song. I hope you will like it, guys. I'm still searching for it, sorry. Okay, this one. Tonight, it's been years, we met each other here. Here I am, all alone, and thoughts of you, God was. Hear me crying out to you. You said never, never would I leave. It's a tear from me to you. And maybe it will make you hear me. I love you. You didn't feel the same. Though we're apart, you're in my heart. Give me one more chance to make it real. In a dream, you are here. You smile and hold me near. In my heart, I'll pretend that you are here again. Hear me crying out to you. You said never, never would I leave. It's a tear from me to you. And maybe it will make you hear me. I love you. You didn't feel the same. Though we're apart, you're in my heart. Give me one more chance to make it real. Make a love shout out to everyone. I love you. You didn't feel the same. Though we're apart, you're in my heart. Give me one more chance to make it real. Give me one chance to make it real. Thank you.
Hey, Cher, I'm going to try something else that I haven't done since.
Okay.
It wasn't a tribute band I was in. It was the last band I was in before I did tribute bands.
Okay,
it was called Blind Cold and Crazy, and I was the youngest in that group. A lot of them were Leonard's age, right around Leonard's age. So that's why when I joined them, I learned a lot of the older tunes that he grew up listening to. And I want you to listen to this one and see what you think. I'm going to be able to do both parts of the song. There were two guys singing this song. I can do both parts, and let me see what you think of it.
All right.
You'll immediately know who this is as soon as I start playing it. Okay. Cher, you'll probably even know this tune, too. Okay, you
ready? Okay.
Hello. Is there anybody in there? Just not if you can hear me. Is there anyone at home? Come on now. I hear you feeling down. Well, I can ease your pain and get you on your feet again.
receding. A distant ship smoke on the horizon. You were only coming through in waves. Your lips move, but I can't hear what you're saying. When I was a child, I had a fever. My hands felt just like two balloons. Now I got that feeling once again. I can't explain, you'll not understand. This is not how I am.
Thank you.
Yeah, those guys taught me a lot of Pink Floyd that I didn't know.
Wow.
That was good. I have not heard that for a long time.
Yeah, Joe Detty was a big Pink Floyd fan, and he couldn't stand the fact that I really wasn't a major fan of Pink Floyd, but I can sound more like them than he could.
Yeah, nice. You can sing more, Sean, because I cannot sing now because of I was trying to draw here. And I really enjoy your music.
But playing in bands, I would have never played any Pink Floyd had it not been for, I was working at a Kroger store and Joe Detty came working there and he was in a band. They were looking for a bass player. I'm like, well, I play some heavy stuff. And they're like, okay. We worked through it and the lead guitarist looked like a biker, but man, he could play and sound, make it sound just like the record too. And he told me the note and we'd be playing, he'd be yelling at me, E! And then he'd be playing some more, G! He'd be yelling at me. His name was Joe Holleran. There were two Joes in the band, but he passed away and that's what killed the band. And I'm like, finding a guitar player like him that didn't become famous. He could have become famous. That's how good he was. He was like flawless. He could be drunk and still play. There's one guitar player that I knew. He couldn't play sober. He was garbage sober. But when he was drunk, oh, he was great. He was one of those functioning drunks. And we briefly played a couple of play. He asked me, come and play with us for a couple of times. We got a replacement, but he can't play. And I remember seeing him play as a kid, and his name was Richard. And so we named the group Whiskey Dick. He's like in his
late 80s,
but he can play. Like all day long, he'd be just sipping Budweisers all day long and playing music. I've never seen him sober but a couple of times, and he tried to play it, and it sucked.
Yeah. So do you have any songs that you wanted to sing?
I got to search.
All right. I'll sing one song, okay? But this is my last song now. And then... when it going to be end, you will be the one who will sing for the end of the song. I don't know. I'm going to sing mellow songs only for now because there's a people sleeping here. You ready? Where is it? I'll sing one song here. I never tried this one, but I like to sing this song because it reminds me something. This one.
I have something to tell you, and I know it won't be easy. I've been thinking this past few days, it might be the time to leave. You're like a stranger. Then you're a lover. Never the same. Always hard to believe. I'm caught between goodbye and I love you. Never know, quite understand. I'm caught between goodbye and I love you.
falling both ways, nowhere to land. So constantly stranded, I can't understand it. This noble life you handed me, it's like the devil and the deep blue sea. Make a little shout out to everyone. If we go on much longer, if my doubts grow any stronger, then I may have to let you go, if only to survive. Give me a reason. Why should I stay here? I've tried so hard just to keep love alive. I'm caught between goodbye and I love you, never knowing quite where I stand. I'm caught between goodbye and I love you, falling both ways, nowhere to land. So constantly stranded, I can't understand it. This double life you handed me, it's like the devil and the deep blue sea. Yeah, thank you very much, guys. Okay, Sean, it's your turn.
Can't do Aria Speedwagon without doing some sticks. I'll give this one a shot. There's quite a few songs with this very same title, but the songs are completely different. All right, I'll try Lady.
When you're with me, I'm smiling. Give me all your love. Your hands build me up when I'm sinking. Touch me and my troubles are fade. Lady, from the moment I saw you standing, oh, 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 you gave all my love that I needed. So shy, like a child who had grown. When you lay down beside me,
gently into your arms. You're my lady. Oh, morning. Love shines in your eyes. Sparkling, clear and lovely. You're my lady. Lady of the morning. Love shines in your eyes. Sparkling, clear and lovely. You're my lady.
One of my favorite songs.
Oh, yeah, Styx is great. I just would like to see him one time with Dennis DeYoung. All the times I've seen him, they didn't have him with him. They had somebody else.
No.
Nice voice, John.
That was good. You hit that and right on the head.
Yeah, but doing Dennis DeYoung is not easy either.
No.
So if you have any song, just continue it. And then later, I will end up my stream because I will take a little rest because later, you know that Blessed Life will be live.
Yeah, you might want to take a nap, Sheer.
Yeah.
Huh?
You may want to take a nap before 5 o'clock.
Yeah, I know. I guess... are you going to sing now or we end up the live stream now?
No, you can end it now so you can get at least 3 hours.
It's almost 3 hours. So thank you very much, guys, for coming up in my panel, especially to you. Sorry about that.
Share you.
Sorry, my brother has a sleep apnea. And every time he woke up, he's shouting because he's running out of air. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have it too. I was treated for it about 22 years ago.
Yeah. We will try to bring him to the doctor because he's already complaining that he's always have a chest pain. And the chest pain is already spreading until to his shoulder. So we are worried about that.
He doesn't want to be yet.
My brother is 39 years old.
Yeah, he needs a machine. Once he gets the machine and uses it, he'll feel so much better.
You know, I will tell you something. He's just like Ellie. But my brother is different. He has a severe depression.
Yeah, but that won't go away. It'll change his behavior. He won't snap real so easily anymore because he's getting quality sleep. He really needs for it.
Yeah. So thank you very much, guys. Okay, so we will take a little nap now. Sean, are you excited later?
Yeah, sure. Well, I like it that Blessed Life was thinking about me that whole day or probably wanting that to sing that song.
What about you, Leonard? Are you excited? Are you happy that you are here in my live stream?
Oh, yes. I'm always happy when I'm in your live streams.
Yeah, thank you very much, Leonard. And thank you very much, Sean. Okay. And thank you very much to Sam Chronicles, to Warren RCG, and to the rest of the people here. Okay. So good night now, guys. Okay. Bye.
One of these days, I'm going to get brave and try to sing.
Yeah. I will do a live stream soon. Painting, and you will be the singing.
Yeah. Huh? Well, all I've got is my phone, besides my computer. So I don't know if you can even hear the music. So we'll have to experiment and try it.
Leonard,
you can do that. Don't worry.
Yeah, what was that, Sean?
You're going to be in Blessed Life live stream too, aren't you?
well, I'm going to be there, but I don't think I'll be on a panel.
Yeah. Yeah.
Huh?
She can fit 10 people.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I've seen it with 7 or 8.
Yeah. So.
I'll see you.
So, guys, I will end up now. Okay. Thank you very much. Okay.
All right, Cher. Thank you so much for having me.
Okay. Okay. Bye. Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.